all of us get to use sidearm in airsoft games. Many of us will use pistols. This is a list of mine. This is my Raven 1911. This was my first ever sidearm. It's a gas blowback rifle. This is my WE knocked up Nighthawk 1911 gas blowback. An iconic Uzi with a phenomenal fire rate. My completely oversized Desert Eagle. This is a TM and has a fantastic kick. Look at the size of this thing. Compare it to the 1911. It's a big gun. But it's fun. And for those of you that likes a different challenge, this is my tri-shot pump action shotgun. All of these guns I've used and are great, but there's one gun that I use which is always consistent, always never lets me down. Welcome to the WE Tech new series GEN4 G18C. Inside the box you get a manual. Manual's good. The English is quite good. It's clear. It's good pictures. It's informative. And it's got a great breakdown. These are really useful. On the back it's got the rules on what to do and what not to do. And I always say that you should read these. Ah. So inside the box, first of all, you get this metal magazine. It's a big, heavy magazine. It's double stacked. The numbers on the back are the same as the real Glock to show how many bullets you've got left. These are two extendable grips. The speckling on there as well. So if you've got a larger hand, they click onto the back of the receiver and make it more comfortable for you to hold. I should have a cleaning tool in here, but unfortunately I haven't got that. And this is just the clip that fastens the extending onto the back of the handle. Here it is, my beaten up, battle-worn G18C with a threaded barrel and the full automatic. Sounds great. As I say, this has been used quite a lot, so I'm sorry about the wear and tear on it. So let me talk you around the gun. On the back, again, you have the two sights. These are fixed. You have a aluminium top rail and a polymer bottom rail. The handguard, it's a speckling on there. And then obviously your finger grooves on the side, which is really comfortable, even when you're wearing gloves. This enables you to get a really good purchase on the gun. You have your takedown lever. It's ambidextrous on both sides. A picatinny rail on the front for mounting a flash or a laser. And in your safety. Safety is really badly positioned and it's difficult to do even without gloves. But with gloves, you won't get that. It's a really poor design. I can't even get it back off without. You have your injection port and then this cutout as well to make it even more lightweight. On the other side, you have your lock back. And your magazine release, which as I say, is in a strange position. And then obviously the famous patterned Glock trigger. And then what is everyone refers to as the fun switch. Semi and fully automatic. So for me, as I say, you can see how easy it is to drop the magazine, and the magazines drop out because they're heavy. But the button, the release button, is really, it's where I grip the handle. And I have been in a game where I got into a firefight with someone and this happened. That's not the best. Now on my 1911, the grip here is a little bit extended, so the button's a little harder to get, so you don't get the magazine dropping out. So what I've done is bought this rubberized grip, and it fits in beautifully, giving you a lot more grip on there, especially with gloves. But it does mean when you're gripping a gun, it takes my thumb away from the magazine release. And it just stops me from dropping my magazine. It's a good way of trying to keep my magazines. So as I said earlier, the magazine is metal, it's a gas magazine. The gas valve is at the bottom here, and on that bottom cap is a little button that helps you to take the cap off. It is a double stack magazine, it gets between 25 and 30 bullets in there. And the numbers on the back, as I say, to show you where the bullets would be in the real magazine. So to load it, again, just place the BBs in the top, push them in, I hold the spring down. You can see it's a double stack on there. Or you can use a speed loader. Makes it much quicker and easier. I'm sure you will know how to put a magazine in a gun. Just slide it in the bottom, you can see it engaging, ready to fire with a gas nozzle. At this point, safety glasses are recommended. So you can get extended magazines for this, and it would come out, I'll show you about there, and that's got a 50 round shot in there. It will empty a whole magazine for the 50 round, but not much gas left. This is what the gun looks like. Or just take loads of magazines to the game with you. If you don't know how to fill up, you're in trouble. Push in and waste loads of gas. Okay, so when I went to do the chromo, it had been a very cold morning, there'd been frost, and when I went to test the gun, it was shooting at 250, 270, down to 220 there. And I figured that that probably wasn't great. The gun usually shoots around about 300 to 320 FPS. So what I did was I took it inside, I warmed the magazine up, and then tried again. A little bit more respectable. But as I say, usually it's around about 300, 310. Using here 0.2s. Hexy. Accurate.
kind of like doing training now.
Fuck.